So hey guys, welcome back to the car show by Harsh Jolly today. And today we'll be shooting the all new 2019 Ford Endeavor. So you already might be knowing that this is a full 7-seater off-road capability SUV and competes with the likes of the Isuzu MU-F, Toyota Fortuner, as well as the Mahindra Altima G4. So I have done a video on the Toyota Fortuner earlier. So I'll be doing a walk around and a comprehensive review of the Ford Endeavor. And I will also be constantly comparing it with the Ford Endeavor with the Toyota Fortuner, and will be telling you about the features and which one you should actually go in for. So first, let's talk about the specification of this car. So this comes with a 2.2-liter 6-speed automatic gearbox which turns about 160 bhp and 385 Nm of torque, and this is the diesel automatic variant. One thing to note is that Ford Endeavor only comes in the diesel variants, whereas the Fortuner does come in petrol variants also. But for such a SUV which has a 2.2 liter engine, you should always go for a diesel engine because it produces more power, and at the same time it's more refined, and the average which it gives is much better, and it's much more fuel efficient. So let's talk about the frontal overview of the car now. So the car looks absolutely stunning and gorgeous, and at the same time gives that muscle car, Ford muscle car feel to it, and it also looks it actually looks stunning, and it just hits your eyes whenever you see it. So let's talk about the headlamps now. So the headlamps, as you can see, are projector headlamps. These are LED headlamps, projector headlamps with xenon, and these are daytime running lamps also, which are LED too. And talking about this large grille, so this is a very bold grille, and you can see these four chrome slats over here which enhance the overall frontal overview of the car. And the color is in red color, as you can see, and these crease lines over here absolutely enhance the look of this car. Now coming to the lower end of the bumper, you can see these are the fog lamps with this silver dual colored bumper, as you can see. So this is a diffuser kind of thing which is offered by Ford, which actually enhances the frontal end of the car and makes it look a lot more sportier. Now let's talk about the features here. There are four parking sensors offered over here which do increase the parking capability of this car, and it makes it a lot more easier because this is a very large vehicle, as you can already see. So that is the case over here, and I think that's all about the frontal end of this car. Now let's talk about the windshield over here. So this windshield has a normal automatic wipers, so that is another very cool thing. And this is all about the frontal end of this car. Now I'll be talking about the tire size and the alloy wheels of this car. So if you have such a big SUV, the tire size and the alloy wheels also should be able to complement the size. So let's talk about the alloy wheels here. So these are 265/60 R18-inch wheels with these diamond-cut, machine-cut alloy wheels which come in a silver and black finish, which absolutely look amazing. And even if you see the space over here, you can actually see the suspension over here. So that actually marks the SUV look of this car, and it actually enhances the overall appeal to the car. Now let's come to the badging over here. 2.2 liter 6-speed automatic with this chrome finish over here looks absolutely amazing. Now these outside rear view mirrors, so these are absolutely huge. So you can see they offer a large view capability, so that is quite good. There are LED indicators also, and these are LED electrically adjustable as well as retractable, so that is another cool thing. Now let me show you the key fob of this car. So this is the key fob of this car. As you can see, this is this comes with keyless entry. This is a smart key. This comes with keyless entry and push button start. So that is another very cool thing. This is the chrome finished door handle with the keyless entry button. There is a sidestep on offer as well, because this car has a very large ground clearance. So to enter the car, you actually need the sidestep, which is a very viable option offered by Ford. And this is the chrome door handle for the rear end as well. So let's talk about the alloy wheels over here. These are same size alloy wheels, the mud flap over here. And now this is all about the side view of the car. As I've already told you, there are roof rails on offer which are actually functional, and you can use these to store luggage over here. There is the antenna over here. And now we'll be telling you about the rear end and the interior of the car in the next few shots. So guys, now we'll be talking about the rear end of this car. So let me first give you a rear overview of this car. So the car looks absolutely amazing from the rear end as well, which is not the case with most other cars in the Indian market, but this car looks amazing from the rear end as well. It has a very large and chunky look to it, and even the rear windshield is extremely large, so it increases the practicality while driving. and this is a large chunky bumper which is again finished in a silver diffuser finish. So there's a dual finish offered to the bumper as well. There are four parking sensors offered over here with a reverse parking camera which are used for the parallel parking feature also, which I'll be telling you about in the next shot. And let's talk about the finish over here. There is this insulation type of thing provided over here so that when you put luggage inside, it does not scratch the original body paint of the vehicle. Now let's talk about the boot. So one cool feature with this key fob is that when you press this button twice, the boot opens to its full position. So this is the electric boot lid opening function offered over here, and you can do the same by pressing it again and the boot will close. Now I will be telling you about the other features offered over here. So there is this rear defogger offered over here. This is the integrated defogger, a high LED high stop lamp, and this is the rear washer wiper with washer offered over here. And there is this large Endeavor branding over here with this chrome finish, which actually looks amazing with this car. And there is this titanium branding over here, which is the variant of this car. And now I'll be just opening the boot and telling you about the space which this car offers. So this, as you can see, this is the electric boot lid opening button, and the button for the same is provided over here. There is also this handle over here so that you can easily close and open the boot. Now let's talk about the other features over here. So this is the boot tray offered over here, which I'm sure is a part of the accessory. And this is a bag which I've put over here so that you can get an idea of the boot lid capacity over here, because all the seven seats are up right now, so you can have an idea of the space this boot has. And this is the 12 volt charging socket over here. If you can see, there is also space to keep stuff over here, and there is also this hook offered over here. Now let's talk about one of the greatest features, which is the first in segment feature Ford offers in this car, which is the electric folding seats for the last row. So this is actually quite useful. So you can actually use this to fold the seats and you can make it flat. So that is another cool feature, and you can also open it. So these come back to their original position using this button itself, which is another very cool thing. And you can also fold the second row of this car, which can open up to a flat bed in which you can put a lot of stuff. So that is another very cool thing. Now let's talk about the boot lamp over here. There is this LED boot lamp offered over here, which again increases the practicality at night. And talking about the spare wheel of this car, the spare wheel has been mounted below itself. So that is another thing which is which all SUVs mostly have. Even the Fortuner has that. And if I would like to compare the space with Fortuner over here, you'll be getting the video of my Fortuner video in the I button coming above. And you can actually compare it, and this has a little bit of more space than the compared to the Fortuner. So that is another plus point which this car offers. And now you can actually just press this and the boot closes totally to its original position. So this is another very cool thing offered. So guys, now we'll be talking about the door over here. So let me open the door, and one thing you'll notice over here is that the build quality of this car. So this door is extremely heavy, and you can actually hear the thud while you close the door, which you hear in German cars mostly. So that is another very cool thing. Now let's talk about the door quality and the finish offered over here. So these are these two electric lock and unlock buttons offered over here. This is this chrome finished door handle offered, which absolutely looks amazing, and the quality is top notch used over again. And this is this glossy black door handle again, which is a plastic sort of finish, but it looks premium again. It's heavy quality plastic. And there is the soft leather upholstery offered over here with this beige threading also. So it looks good as an overall. If you have a look at the interior, it looks good. The interior has been finished in beige, and these glossy black handles complement the interior. And there is also this large cubby hole offered over here in which you can store a 1 liter bottle and some small knickknacks. And there is also the speaker grill over here, and I'll be telling you about the audio quality and the music system in the later part of this video. So guys, as you can see, I'm in the third row of this car, and getting into the third row was not a very easy task. So here I would rate the Fortuner higher, and Fortuner has an upper hand in the rear seat comfort. But let me just pull this seat and give you an idea. So this seat can be pulled over here, and as you can see, my knees are totally like up, and I don't have any under thigh support. Headroom is also okay, and taller people will have a problem over here. It is quite cramped up over here because even the quarter glass over here is not very large, so the cabin does not feel very airy over here. But still, two children can sit over here, and only one adult can sit over here for long journeys. So I won't really recommend this third row for seating people except for children, but you can always fold these and use this as a luggage bay, so that is not a problem at all. Talking about the amenities offered over here, there is this light over here, white light. AC vents have been offered on the roof of this car, so those are quite practical over here and quite successful too. And there is also a coat hook offered over here with cup holders on both sides. So overall, I'll rate this cabin 5 out of 10 for seating people, because there's not much space over here, but Ford has taken care of the safety part of it. So you do have these seat belts offered over here, which are offered with a retractable function. That is another cool feature, and this is all about the third row of this car. So now we'll be talking about the second row of this car. So most people will be sitting in the second row in the first passenger seat of this car. So the third row does not really make sense for seating people, as I've already told you. So let's have a look over here. So first I'll be telling you about the whole color scheme used. So there is a black tone used on the roof, and there is this beige tone which gives the car a lot more airy feeling, which is not the case in the Fortuner, because they use tan and dark brown color upholstery, so it does not feel as airier. So let's talk about the floor bed over here. So there is a slight hump offered over here, so this can be a problem for seating a third passenger, but you can always look at the positives of this cabin too, because there is triple zone climate control offered over here. So there's one zone for the passenger, one zone for the driver, and there's a third zone for the second row and the third row passengers. So you can actually adjust the modes over here, and you can control the fan speed and the temperature, although you do not get a temperature display over here, which you do get in the Toyota Fortuner, but that is not a very big problem over here. And there is also 12 volt charging socket offered. Now let's talk about the overall seating experience. So the headroom is not very much, but it's ample for a person of about 6 feet. For reference, I am of a height about of 5 feet and 8 inches, so I'm comfortable over here. I have good amount of under thigh support, knee room, leg room, and you can see I can stretch my legs in the space over here also, which makes the overall cabin feel quite comfortable. And if I stretch back myself, I'm quite comfortable over here, and I can also adjust this seat by pulling it forward back and forth, so that is not a problem. And you can also increase the space for the third row passengers using this, so that it won't be a problem. Now talking about this panoramic sunroof over here, which is one of the greatest selling points of this car, because the other competitors in the segment do not have this. And this is a full panoramic sunroof, only the front part of the sunroof opens, so opening this also makes the cabin a lot more airier, and you won't feel claustrophobic inside. And one thing to note is that Fortuner does not have this feature, so that is a negative for the Fortuner, and the Endeavor scores over this. And there's also this reading lamps offered on both sides, and there are these AC vents which actually hit your head, so those are quite successful in the summer times. And this is all about the seating experience over here. Talking about the seats, three people can sit over here, one child and two adults can sit, because there is a slight hump over here. So if I tell you the seating experience for the second person over here, so it won't be very comfortable, because there are these seat belts, the sockets over here, and my knees are totally up, so I don't have any under thigh support, so that may be a negative for the third person, but overall the cabin feels quite airy. Now let's talk about the headrests over here. So there are three headrests, and there is also this handrest over here, which is also leather finished in this beige leather upholstery offered. And there are two cup holders offered over here, which is another very cool feature, so you can just retract this whenever you want to, and you can also fold this to increase space to the third passenger. So this is all about the second row of this cabin. So guys, let's talk about the front door now. So I'll be entering into the driver's seat once I just explain all this. So this is the leather finish offered over here. It's just like the same I showed you in the rear door. So there's a beige stitching over here, leather stitching again. And these are the controls for all four power windows, which are all one touch up and down. So that is another great feature. And there is this black glossy handle provided over here with this black finish offered over here too. And there's this chrome door handle with the lock and unlock buttons over here. So that is again a premium touch, because these are electric and not the manual ones which you get in other cars. And this is the door, the cubby hole offered over here with a 1 liter bottle holder and a small cubby hole again, so that is not a problem. And in entering into the car, you can see the ingress and egress angles are very easy, so the door opens quite wide, so there'll be no problem entering. You can always use this sidestep to enter the car. And now I'll be showing you all the functions over here. So these are the functions for the automatic headlamps, etc. I'll just show that to you when I start the car. So I've started the car now, and you can see this is the headlamp level adjuster, so you can adjust the height of the headlamp using this. and you can adjust the automatic headlamp buttons over here, and you can just use the headlamps and the toggles for the headlamps over here. This is the instrumental cluster brightness button, so you can increase and decrease the brightness buttons from here, and you can also switch on and off the rear and front fog lamps using this. And this is the electric boot lid opener, so if you press this, the boot lid automatically opens to its full position. There is also this grab handle offered over here, which is another feature which is in common with the Fortuner as well as the Ford Endeavor, because while off-roading you need these grips over here, and so that is another very cool feature. And this is the button for the electrical retracting of the outside rear view mirrors, so you can adjust them, retract them, and you can also adjust them electrically. And there is this AC vent offered over here, and there is this black finish which runs throughout the dashboard across with the soft touch leather finish. So this is all about the driver seat over here. So we'll be starting about the frontal and the interior of this car. So one thing I would like to say is that the interior is extremely premium. There's a use of soft touch leather, white stitching across the dashboard, including the steering wheel. Even the steering wheel is extremely well stitched with, again, a different color stitching, which absolutely looks stunning. There is this three-tone dashboard offered over here. So the first layer has leather, the second layer has this glossy grey and black kind of finish, and there is this beige finish which makes the cabin feel a lot more airier. Now I'll be talking about the steering wheel. So the steering wheel is large and chunky, and it offers a very good grip. So that is one of the premium design features Ford has offered. There are steering controls which I'll be telling you about later, which are linked to this touchscreen infotainment system, and I'll be telling you about the features in detail too. And let's talk about the buttons over here. So there is this volume button for the instrument for this music system, touchscreen music system, the tuning button over here. There's this button for the instrument cluster seat track buttons, and there's dual zone climate control offered over here. So you can change the passenger temperature for both the passengers differently, and there's also a triple zone climate control. Third zone is offered in the second row of seat, so you can use that to increase and decrease the fan speed. I'll decrease it right now, and you can see the 6-speed automatic gearbox, which is one of the greatest highlights of this vehicle because it is famous for the 6-speed gearbox only. And this is all about this features over here. Now let's talk about some extremely nice first-in segment features. This is the parking sensor button. So this car has parking sensors all around the car, so this will increase your parking experience and it will make it easier to park this large vehicle. And there is also parallel park offered over here. So using the parallel park, you can just use the indicators to find a parking and it will help you park. So that is another very cool feature with using it, and you can switch it off here. And now let's talk about the safety features offered over here. So this car has ABS, EBD, and it also has airbags as well as ESP, traction control, brake assist, hill hold control. There are some safety features offered over here. The number of airbags this car has will be flashing on the screen, so you can have a look at that too. And there are these 4 AC vents over here, which are quite effective. And the AC is switched on right now, and I can actually feel it cooling right now. So that is another very cool thing. This is the hazard light button over here. And having a look at the cubby holes over here. So there is this 2 cubby holes over here, which are not cool. There is a small cubby hole again, and there is this space to put the USB, and you can also put your phone inside. So that is quite practical. Again, there is a 12-volt charging socket as well as another USB port over here. There is a start stop button over here, using which you can start and stop the button. So you can press the play button and start it again. And there is also this option for the armrest over here, which is leather finished again, so you can keep a lot of stuff inside, and you can also remove this tray and move this. So that is another very cool thing. And the handbrake is a manual handbrake. So one thing to note is that this car has a manual handbrake, and other cars in this segment have electronic handbrakes, but the Fortuner as well as the Endeavor have manual handbrakes, which is a positive feature for when you're off-roading. But this can be a negative feature for people who opt for luxury vehicles which cost about 40 lakhs. So that is something which Ford should have provided. And this car also has differential lock control, so while off-roading you can lock the differentials. So that is another very cool thing. Talking about the toggles over here, this car has automatic headlamps as well as automatic wipers. So I've already told you about that. And let's have a look at the glove box over here. So this glove box is extremely large, and it can hold a large amount of stuff, and it has a small cubbyhole also for files which you can keep. So that is a very good thing again. And it has only a single glove box, whereas Fortuner has 2 glove boxes. So that is again a negative point which for some people. And this is all about the frontal end of this car. Now let's talk about the panoramic sunroof, which is one of the main highlights of this car. So using this button over here, you can open the sunshade. As you can see, the sunshade for the frontal and the frontal part of the sunroof will open, and to open the rear panoramic sunshade, you have to pull this and you can open the sunshade over here, so it becomes a very good feature for the rear passenger as well. And there are these kind of sunroofs are offered in the Jeep Compass as well, and other luxury cars like the ML350, Mercedes or the Q7, which also have these luxury features. And this is the this sun visor offered over with lights, and this is offered in a very different color, which is this black color, and not many cars have this in this grayish blackish tone. And there is this also sunlight sunglass holder offered over here, and there are these two lights offered over here for which the controls are provided over here, and there are the sunroof controls also, so you can close the sunroof using this button. And there is also this sun visor with lights offered over here. So this is all about the frontal end of this car. So guys, now I'll be telling you about the 8-inch touchscreen infotainment system which Ford offers in this car. And one thing to note is that this touchscreen infotainment system is standard across all variants, so that is another cool thing. And let's talk about the features offered over here. So these are the controls for the volume rocker. For the music system, this is the tune button, and there's the seek track buttons to fast forward or pause the songs which are playing on this music system. You can connect your phone using Apple CarPlay, USB, AUX and Bluetooth, and you can also use inbuilt navigation which the system offers, so that is another very good thing. Talking about the infotainment, the AC controls over here, so this car comes with automatic climate control, two zone automatic climate control for the front driver as well as the passenger, and there's a third zone for the rear passengers as well. So we'll be talking about the dual zone climate control. So let me press this button over here, and using this you can reduce the blower speed and the modes etc, which you can do in every other car, but there are two zones for the driver as well as the passenger, so that is another very good thing. Let's talk about the features over here. So there's this USB port over here, 12 volt charging socket over here. This is the a button for the air conditioner, so you can switch on and off using this. And there's these buttons for the parallel parking. So if you want to use parallel parking, you just have to press the indicator in which you can see an empty parking lot, and the car will find space and help you park itself. And there is also automatic wipers as well as automatic headlamps offered in this car. Now there's the traction control button offered in this car. So I've already told you about the traction control, hill hold control, slip differential lock, brake assist, ESP and other features, ABS, CVT, which this car offers. So it has all the safety controls which every upmarket luxury car has. There is this glossy finish offered over here as well, and around the screen, which makes it look premium again. This is the hazard light button offered. This is a 6-speed automatic gearbox, which is a very successful gearbox offered in this car and is a very trustworthy gearbox. And I've already told you about the manual handbrake, the hand rest and the two cup holders offered here too. Now let me tell you about the buttons over here. So if I switch off parallel parking and get in the home button, so you can see there's this compass thing, which compass you can connect a phone. There's the FM option, audio option, using which you can connect either to different frequencies, the radio frequencies. These are the setting options, the sound, radio, clock etc. So using this you can set the clock format, you can connect your phone using Bluetooth. These are the general options, using which you can change the normal settings of this music system. There's emergency assistance offered by Ford in this car, which is offered in many other cars as well. And there's automatic updating for the instrumental system, so that is another good feature. You can update this music system, and you can have other features in this music system too. There is voice command offered, valet mode, ambient light. You can change the colors of this ambient light, so you can change it to red, blue, green, the ice blue, orange. These are different colors which are offered. There's this display also, so using this you can adjust the brightness, auto dimming options etc. There is this vehicle option which tells you about the tire pressure monitoring system, camera settings, in which you can delay the reverse parking camera or while driving, which enhances the rear visibility also while driving. There is the phone option, which I've already told you about. Navigation is another very cool feature, so using this you can actually navigate. This is the inbuilt navigating system. There are mobile apps using which you can connect a device. There's the phone options using which you can pair, the climate control option which I've already told you about. The clock and outside temperature is also shown over here, and the Wi-Fi button is also offered, so there is system Wi-Fi on offer as well. and I can get to the home button again, and you can have a look at the home screen of this music system. So this is all about this music system which offers, and even the audio quality is quite good of this music system, because this has a lot of speakers, and the audio quality offered by Ford in this car is quite good, so that is will not be a problem for any buyer of this car. So guys, now I'll be telling you about the multi-information display which this car offers. So this car has two digital displays alongside one analog conventional speedometer which is offered, which shows the speed of top speed of about 200 kilometers per hour. And below that you can see the PRNDS option, which stands for parking, reverse, neutral, drive and sport mode, which this car offers. So I'm right now in the car is in park mode, so you can see it showing park mode. And the other two displays will show, so the right display shows all the conventional information including the RPM meter, the fuel gauge, as well as the total kilometers the car has been driven, and the other warnings like the door open warning, etc., the engine light warning which every car shows. And the screen to the left of the analog meter shows conventional information like the navigation, telephone, etc., and also shows the basic FM radio, etc., options. So if you're using any FM or your phone is connected to your to Bluetooth, etc., so using that you can have a look at it, and it shows basically all information you need while driving, so that you not get distracted at, with the 8-inch touchscreen infotainment system offered, and it enhances your driving capability and does not distract you as well. So it provides a lot of information and is a comprehensive thing which offers most information about the about the screen of the car, and also has information about the tire pressure monitoring system, etc., the engine oil warning, the brake oil warning, etc., which this car has. So guys, this car has a very good feature of cruise control also. So using this you can activate cruise control and set the speed you want to, and you can constantly increase and decrease it using the buttons provided over here. So it makes your driving very easy on highways when you're driving long distances, and also reduces your fatigue level. So that is another safety and practical feature offered by Ford in this car. So guys, thank you for watching this video. Please like, share, subscribe, and also comment down your suggestion below. And do tell me if you like this video and if you like the car. And do comment down your suggestion below about this video. And this was a differently short video and was shot with Tejas Sharma. This was in collaboration with Tejas Sharma. And you can have a look at his Instagram account, which is Executive Lounge. I'll be giving the link in its description box below. And he uploads photos and videos of exotic cars in Delhi NCR. So you can have a look at that too. And he also has YouTube channel, and I'll be giving you the link of that YouTube channel in the description box below also. And do follow me on Instagram, dude. That is the car show underscore by R Jolly, and I do give latest automobile updates on that too. Thank you for watching this video.